Hello, everybody. I am FlamingFlarez. Welcome to more Let's Play Leaf Green. Pokemon Leaf Green, that is. You're probably wondering what the hell I'm doing on Route 2. Well, what we are going to do is we are going to catch us a legendary Pokemon. That's right. We are going to get a very special legendary Pokemon that can only be found in wild places. Yes. So basically what you want to do is you want to have a Pokemon. Holy crap! That wasn't planned at all! Holy! I didn't even get done explaining what you had to do! Oh my god! It's Entei! It's the Pokemon we're looking for! Huh! Oh my god! Oh my god! Now just imagine if that was shiny, how I would freak out. That would have been even funnier, you know. But no, it's not shiny. Anyway, basically what you have to do is you have to have a Pokemon below level 50. I happen to have a Poliwrath at 28. And you throw a Repel on, you run around in the wild grass, and if it doesn't appear, you go exit the map, come back to the map, and basically what you do is, the trick is that you're on Route 2, right up by Viridian Forest, and if it doesn't appear, like, after so many steps, you go into the building between, to get into Viridian Forest, and then you come out and you go through it again, and it's a big whole convoluted thing. This is the Pokemon that gives people the most trouble in this game. Basically, this is why I didn't tell you to use the Master Ball on Mewtwo. Because Mewtwo is easy to catch in an Ultra Ball. But then there's Entei. Entei is kind of difficult to catch in any Pokeball except for the Master Ball. Now, Entei has a catch rate of 3. That means with a normal Pokeball on the first turn, without doing anything to it, you have a 0.4% chance of catching it in one single Pokeball. You can get extremely lucky and get it, or, you know, that means that 4 Pokeballs in every 1,000 tries is going to catch this full health, no status inflictions. That is basically what that means. And interpret that as you will, with the Great Ball being double the Pokeball, and the Ultra Ball being double the Great Ball, then the Master Ball is just instant. Now, the whole reason everyone is always like, keep your Master Ball for Entei is because it can flee. That's right. It can run away from you. If it gets the chance to run away, it will run away. So basically, there's multiple strategies to do. Since I don't have a Pokemon to do the strategy I wish to do, I am just going to throw the Master Ball. That's right. I'm going to throw the Master Ball. Now, something I would like to explain is that the legendary Pokemon you run into, the Johto Legendary Beast that you run into here, will not always be Entei. If you chose Bulbasaur, it will always be Entei. If you chose Charmander, it will always be Suicune. If you chose Squirtle, it will always be Raikou. Anyway, here we got number 244, Entei, Volcano Pokemon, height 6 foot 11 inches, almost 7 feet tall. Weight 436 and a half pounds. There's its footprint, there's its sprite. Volcanoes erupt when it barks. Unable to restrain its extreme power, it races headlong around the land. And we are not going to give it a nickname, because I'm not one for nicknames. So yeah, what gives people the most trouble is because it runs away. I'm not going to show that, because it takes forever to find it again. Unless you keep sitting there, but you can, like, after you run into it the first time, it'll be in your Pokedex. And you can go check your Pokedex, like such. I'm just going to use an example, you know, Bulbasaur. Then you'd hit A to go to next, and then it would show you the area, and then, like, it'd have a red splotch, like, Let me get to a Pokemon I can actually find in the wild, like Caterpie. It has those red splotches at the area where it is. So, yeah, very basic. We're only 5.5 minutes into this video, and I've already got the thing done. Where is it? Oh, it's right there. We'll move you down here. We'll move Poliwrath back. And we'll move Clefable back into the team. And Entei is right there. It's a Lex nature, Meta Route 2 at level 50. It's a fire type. Its strengths would be its attack and its speed. Compare. Ember Roar, Fire Spin, and Stomp. Now, the strategy I was planning on doing was using a Pokemon with Mean Look to keep it from running away. The problem with that strategy with Entei and I think Raikou, I'm not sure about Suicune, is that they have Roar. If they use Roar, that's just like KOing them. They're gone for good. So you always want to save before you go hunting for these Pokemon, unless you're going to catch it in the Master Ball. Now, what the strategy I wanted to do was use that exact same strategy and catch it in an Ultra Ball or a Pokeball, even. I mean, any Pokeball except for the Master Ball. Happened to catch it in the Master Ball. And now we actually have Legendaries. We got the Pokeball. We got the Great Ball. We have 2 Ultra Balls, and we have a Master Ball. How great can this get? I mean, if you could get, like, the Premier Balls in this, I would have caught Moltres in that, and yeah. But yeah, there's our legendary Pokemon, and now what we are going to do is I'm going to prepare my Pokemon for the final battles, the final 5 battles of the game. That's right, we're going to go after the Elite Four and the Champion once again. So, if you have to delete moves, I recommend going to Fuchsia, because it's colors, Fuchsia City. I believe Fuchsia is like a tone of pink or something. I would explain the colors of the buildings. Come talk to this guy. Yes, I am the move deleter. I can make Pokemon forget their moves. Would you like me to do that? The move deleter will be able to get rid of any move, including HMs. He's basically there to get rid of the HMs. So we'll get rid of Rock Smash on Primeape, and we'll just replace it with a HM. It NHM or AHM? I don't know how to do that. I think Clefable's the only one besides Dodrio. I think the rest of them have the good HMs on. Oh, wait. Vaporeon has Waterfall, and I don't want Waterfall. You only need Waterfall for the Icefall Cave or whatever it is. Ice Cavern. Ice Cave is... I don't remember what it is anymore. But we're gonna go to Vaporeon, and we're gonna get rid of Waterfall and replace it with something better. If you happen to have any like tiny mushrooms or big mushrooms, you can let's see if I have any before I explain this. I don't think I do. Oh yeah, I do. I have a tiny mushroom. You need 2 tiny mushrooms or a big mushroom. Yeah. If you have 2 tiny mushrooms or a big mushroom, you can head to 2 Island, and the house right next to the game corner will, you can talk to the guy in there, and he will give you, or he will allow you to reteach your Pokemon moves they learned through level up, which is really awesome, because, yeah, well, yeah, it's just awesome. So basically now we have a Vaporeon that needs another move and a Primeape that needs another move. Alright, sorry about that cut. I had to go do something really quick. Yeah, so we got a Primeape that and a Vaporeon that needs a move learned. Let's see what we have in our TM case. Do we have anything good? We have Dragon Claw. Ooh. Who can learn Dragon Claw? I don't think either of them can. None of them can. TM. Sludge Bomb. I want to teach that to Venusaur. Because, you know, Venusaur would get same type attack bonus from it. It's 90 power. Honestly, I don't think Frenzy Plan is really the best move, but, yeah. I think I'm going to get rid of Double Edge. I know it's a move tutor move and can never be learned again, but I think having Razor Leaf and Frenzy Plant is better than just Frenzy Plant, because then we have something that can attack multiple turns in a row. Fable can learn Fire Blast too, but I'm not going to teach it. Aerial Ace. I don't want to teach that to... I'm going to fly over to Celadon and see if I can find any TMs to buy. I believe you sell the TMs? Yep. Dig, Brick Break. I think I already taught Brick Break the Primeape, right? Yeah. See, there's not very many good TMs late in the game. It's kind of hard to find TMs, except for on your travels. So, yeah. I don't know. What else we got here? Who can learn Solar Beam? Well, Fable would be able to learn Solar Beam. Teach Return to Primeape, I guess. Why not? And... I don't know what I can teach to... Vaporeon. Who can learn Rock Tomb besides Primeape? Nobody. Learn Aerial Ace besides Primeape and Dodrio. Nobody can learn Dragon Claw. That kind of sucks, because that'd be awesome to have. I need an Ice move. That's what I need. Besides Blizzard. I need, like, Ice Beam or something. I also need to, like, grind off screen or something. I don't know. I think the levels are just fine. It gives me a challenge. Yeah. Alright, I think I know where I can go. I have to go to the game corner. How many coins do I have? None. How much cash do I have? None. That would figure. Well then I'll just abandon the thought of getting Ice Beam then. Well, I'll figure this out in between parts. So, next time on Pokemon Leaf Green. Let's play Pokemon Leaf Green, I should say. We are going to go to the Elite Four and take them on once more and end off this Let's Play for good. I'll see you guys then.